fun. I always have loved this map because it's just so beautiful and it is so fun to play on. So if ASMR is not your thing, then I would highly suggest that you do not watch this video because it's all whispering. I have turned down the volume to the game drastically, intentionally, so that way there's no harsh sounds. And we're just gonna play the game and talk a little bit. I can already tell you guys this map is definitely worth getting, but for entertainment purposes, I thought that I would still review it. I thought that I would still create a video on it, so that way we could, you guys could see it for the first time. So, with that in mind, let's jump right into it. Bloom is a game about cultivation, exploration, and customization. Before we can begin, find the three tools around the garden. As far as the clicking goes for the actual, like, keyboard and mouse, I'm sorry, but I can't really fix that, so I hope that it doesn't bother you too much. The first thing that we need to find are the three tools, and I'm honestly not sure where they are. I don't remember. Oh, here's one. We got the watering can. Need constant watering or else they will decay. Interact with a dry plant to water it. There's one down. We have to find two more. We found some pruners. If you find plants in the wild, interact with them to collect clippings. You can plant clippings on prepared earth. I'm guessing that this is the prepared dirt, but I could be completely wrong. I honestly and truly do not remember. Well, we found one in the middle. We found one to the right. I'm guessing the last is to the left. This is my first time ever creating an ASMR video, and I have to say that the process of creating it is way nicer to me than actually filming a regular video. I really enjoy how calm and quiet. I really like it a lot. I thought that we could cut that down right now, but it turns out we had to find the last one, and we just so happened to come across it. We found the trowel. Interact with dirt to get it ready for planting. These tools will allow you to start growing your very own garden. Use the pruner to gather clippings from the wild plants around you. We have a book, The Garden Guide, a gardener's guidebook. There are six essential tools for any gardener. A trowel, used to prepare dirt for planting. Area, not that the pesky barrier is let me know, and I can completely make more videos. If there is any sort of downside to this map, I would definitely have to say it is just that sometimes in the beginning, there's a lot of waiting. You have to wait for your flowers to be ready to be watered again. While we wait for those to be ready, let's head over to our little house over here and go ahead and put some things inside of our chest, like this garden. Sunflowers yet, so I'll put some in there. And the hydrangeas, we've already planted some, so I'll put those in there as well. I think I'm gonna keep the pollen on me for now, though. Because we're gonna use it. Or is it just by chance that stone looks like a fireplace mantle? And actually, after I played this map the first time, I took this idea and I've used it in homes elsewhere, and it works really well. Nothing burns down. So, with me being wrong about that being the house, that means that this is the house, and this is the, like, garden shed, or the storage room, however you'd prefer to call that. Oh, I forgot to mention before as well that statue that we saw back in the other garden down here, you actually, if you complete the challenges, challenges, and they're secret challenges, you get a special flower that doesn't grow wild. Like, all of these flowers, they grow wild, but the ones that you get from this guy, and there's multiple others scattered around this world, you get a special secret flower, and you can choose to plant it wherever you'd like. And I think, I might be wrong, but once you have the flower, you can plant it, you can water it, you can place it wherever you'd like to place it, and once it's fully grown, you can use your songwriter.